Hi, and welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Liz, and today I am here with Bashira from IHS Markit. Hey, Bashira, how's it going?
Doing great.
Well, thanks for joining us today.
Happy to be here.
Can you tell me a little bit about IHS Markit?
Yeah, IHS Markit offers information analytics technology and expertise to our customers so that it can be operationally efficient and make well-informed decisions.
Excellent. And today we are going to be talking about a virtual software training, right?
Yep. So basically, we have a product called Kingdom. It's a petrotechnical application, and it requires high-end configurations with GPU support to make it run. And what we're doing is we're using AppStream to deliver that software. And basically, whenever it's time for class, students just click on a streaming URL, and that's it. It's ready to go.
So they can one-click log into AppStream from pretty much any lightweight end user device.
Yep. They don't even have to log in. It's a streaming URL, so it's just Kingdom on the browser right there.
So what does that architecture look like then?
Okay, so in order for Kingdom to run, it has a license server, and we're using an EC2 for that. And for Kingdom projects, the storage for that, we are using a file system for FSx for the file system, and then RDS for the database. And basically, all of that together makes Kingdom run.
So if an instructor is going to set up one of these classes, what does the instructor need to do?
Okay, so these three resources is what gets created for every single class, right? And we wanted to give the instructors a very easy way to have this running quickly without starting days in advance and just accruing costs when it's not needed. So we've provided them with CloudFormation templates so that they can customize the images the way they need to, and also create the resources very quickly.
So you mentioned that there are a few different kinds of classes. What are in those CloudFormation templates?
Okay, so we are using, obviously these resources that we see, RDS and FSx. Mm-hmm. And in addition to that, the images needs to be customized, right? And we need to get that as part of the CloudFormation template. So we have introduced a custom resource. Mm-hmm. And basically what this does is it triggers a Lambda function. And we want to be able to remote into the AppStream's image builder and make the customizations that we need, wait for the image to be created, and that can take about 20 to 45 minutes. But with Lambda, we can do that for the 15-minute execution time max, right?
Yep, 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm, and we are using Systems Manager. So basically, Lambda uses Systems Manager to run a command on the EC2 right here. And that does all the magic. It runs a script, removes into the AppStream image builder. One of the customizations that's really important is we have to modify a session script in the image builder, which will make sure that the FSx that just got provisioned in CloudFormation is mounted whenever the customer logs onto AppStream so that they can have access to their project. Once that's done, the EC2 will send a signal back to CloudFormation, and we have a wait condition and handle over here. Mm-hmm. So once it meets those requirements, then AppStream is provisioned using the image we just created.
So it sounds like that's a great way to ensure a really high-quality user experience. Are there any design considerations that have been made for this architecture?
Yeah, so like I mentioned, when we are recommending configurations to customers when they're running Kingdom on their desktops, we ask for very sophisticated GPU-supported CPUs, right? But for classes, we don't need to use that for every single workflow. It's going to be really expensive. So unless a customer is doing 3D visualizations on billions of data points, we are sizing our fleets accordingly. So the CloudFormation template gives the instructors parameters to customize those as well.
That's a great way to align with cost optimization.
Yep.
Any other cost optimization moves you guys have made?
Yeah, so that's like a very easy switch we made with RDS. Usually we have a full SQL server that's running there, but we realize that our projects are very small for the training purposes. Mm-hmm. So just switching from a full SQL server to a SQL Express engine reduced our cost by like 80%.
Wow. Well, thank you for walking me through the architecture, Bashira. It's been very interesting to learn how IHS Markit is enabling virtual instructor-led training for the Kingdom petrotechnical application. Thank you for joining us on This Is My Architecture. I look forward to catching you next time.